Okay, welcome everyone. As we continue our new journey through Bava Metzia, here's Reuven Shannett now. Hold on, let's see what's happening. Hello, Reuven. Yeah,
I see you on the screen. I see Michal also, but I can't. I hear you. Okay, we're hooked up.
Somebody just played around with my screen. Who did that?
I didn't do anything. Oh, there it is. It's back. Okay.
Okay. All right. Very good, Rabbi Isai. So we are sponsored by two sponsors, by A.B. Spry, who is sponsoring the Bavas, that all his children should be healthy Bavas. And by Michal Avram, who is sponsoring the Shir, Lahagdil Torah Ulahadira, and to be Mechazak, all of us in our learning. We want to welcome in the Agudas Yisrael based Eliezer, now Bezev, of Fairways Lakewood. We have over there Michal Avram and Avram Rezepkowitz. We have Saba waiting patiently, Mel Zachter, Moshe Lima, Menachem Mansky, Aaron Swade, Mo Kushner, Irving Fishbaum, Abi Sri, Barchian, Shalom Fogel, Elia Udell, Barry Cement, Dr. Guy, Stephen Holtzman, Yitzi Fuchs, Bruce Eisenberg, Chaim Lerner, Shelley Zeitlin, Gedalia, Barish Gesserman, Nachman Chapler, Yeshua Shmuel Eisenberg, Ilya Schutman, Rabbi Kranz, Mitchell Flom, Abe Arbach, Mati, Chaim Kramer, and we have Philippe joining us, which is really, really nice. And let's just see if we can get everybody here muted. Okay. And we have Sandy Grunfeld joining us and Richard Rosenzweig, David Helfka. Who is playing around with my screen? I don't know who this Mati is, but he's playing around with my screen. Okay, and Jay Siegel has just joined us for our 33rd Zoomer of the evening, and now our 34th Zoomer is joining us as well. Okay, so if you remember, and if you want to know where we're up to, we are towards the bottom of Gimel Amud Beis. Ella Osya Me'ed Echad. We are trying to ascertain where I say to Barry, you owe me $1,000. And Barry says, I owe you nothing. And I bring witnesses that Barry owes me $500. We said that Barry has to swear about the other $500. And now the Gemara is going to learn this out from Eid Echad, as we welcome in Yitzi Padua for our 35th Zoomer of the evening. Says the Gemara, Shimon Klein has joined us. Says the Gemara, Ella Asya Me'ed Echad. We learn it out from one witness. Ma'ed Echad She'ein Mechai V'Maman. One witness cannot be mechayiv somebody money because ain davashev b'mamon pachas mishnayim. But mechayiv yishvua, it makes a person swear. Edim, two witnesses shemechayiv an oisay mamon, that would be mechayiv somebody to pay. Ain oidin shemechayiv an oisay shvua. Surely, if they say that Barry owes me 500, they will make Barry swear about the other 500. Says to Gemara, you're comparing apples and oranges. Mala Eid Echad, when one witness comes and makes Barry swear, that's about what he's saying Barry owes me. Mala Eid Echad Shekein Al Mashu Hu Meyed Hu Nishba. So, for example, if one witness has said that Barry owes me $500, they make Barry swear about the $500. Timer Be'edim, but we want to say that now, if I say, Barry, you owe me $1,000. He says he owes me nothing. And then two witnesses come and say that he owes me 500. We want to make Barry swear about the other 500. He has to swear about the other 500 that he's denying. Who says that you could do that? You can't extrapolate that from an Eid Echad that only makes Barry swear about what they're testifying about. Ela amara papa osi megilgul shvua de Eid Echad. Ah, if one Eid says that Barry owes me money, right? If one Eid says that Barry owes me money, once Barry has to swear about that, and I have another claim on him, so we have a principle of Gilgul Shvua, that once he has to swear about it, we make him swear about my other claim. So you see over there, by an Eid Echad, we make him swear about something else that he's denying. So the Gemara says, oh, that's different. Mala Gilgul Shvua de Eid Echad, Shekein Shvua Gerere Shvua. Once the Eid Echad makes Barry swear about what he testifies about, that Shvua generates that he has to swear other things too. Toimer be'edim demamen kamechayvi. But over here, where I say Barry owes me 1,000, he says nothing, and two witnesses say that he owes me 500, the witnesses only make him pay money. They don't make him swear. So there's no justification to say Gilgul Shvua. So the Gemara says, rather, we're going to go back to the original proof that we said, that we learned it out from an Eid Echad. We said that the Eid Echad only makes Barry swear about what they say. While over here, we want to say the witnesses make Barry swear about the other 500. So the Gemara says, Piv Yoichiach, the mouth will prove it. Because when I demand Barry owes me 1,000 and he admits to 500, so his mouth generates that he has to swear about the other 500, not about what is being spoken about. So the Gemara says, yeah, but we said you can't learn it out from the mouth, because Malapiv Shekein Einoi Ba'achosha. The Barry's mouth, you cannot contradict, because when Barry says he owes me money, that can't be contradicted. So the Gemara says, well, Eid Echad Yoichiach, one witness will disprove you, sheyesh noy ba'achosha, because a witness could be contradicted, and yet umechay v'yishvua. I will say, mala Eid Echad shekein al mashe meyid hu nishpa. By one witness, he only has to swear about what the witness testifies, not about the rest. Toimer be'edim, that we want to say that where witnesses say that he owes me 500, he has to swear about the other 500. Toimer be'edim shal mashe kafer unishpe. Piv yoichiach, the mouth will disprove it, because by the mouth, when he admits to 500, he has to swear about the other 500. So lo roi zekara yizeh, v'lo roi zekara yizeh. One is not like the other. The other is not like the first one. In other words, they each have different features. Hatzada shava shebehen. The common denominator is shal yedei taino ukfira heimban. They come for a claim and Barry's denial. V'nishba, and Barry has to swear. Afani ovi edim, so I'll also say that where I say Barry owes me 1,000, and Barry says he owes me nothing, and witnesses say they owes me 500, there afani ovi edim shall yidei tainu kfireimbam, my claim and Barry's denial, v'nishba, and that Barry has to swear. Says the Gemara, well, but there's a problem, as for some reason Marshall Castle, oh, here he is, he's coming on, and Joseph Isaac Korf has joined us. So says the Gemara, as we finally welcome in Barry, as he at Marshall, as he finally gets around to dropping in, 38th Zoomer of the evening, nice of you to show up.
I just came for the drinks.
Now, Mala Tzada Shova Shebehen, we want to learn it out from a person's own admission and one witness. Malat Sada Shavashibahem, the common denominator, Shekain Loy Hugzik Kafron. Oh, in both the cases, Barry has not been proven to be a liar. Both in the case where I claim 1,000 and he admits to 500, that's Piv, that's Moida B'mixas, he's not been proven to be a liar. Or where one witness comes and says he owes me $500, he is also not proven to be a liar. Timer Be'edim, in the case where I said Barry owe me $1,000, he says he owes me nothing, and then the witnesses say that he owes me $500, so he's been proven to be a liar already. And therefore, since he's been proven to be a liar, maybe we don't accept his shvuah anymore because he's hulzik kafron, says the Gemara. Not so fast. I mean, Barry is Barry, but it's not so fast that he's established to be a liar. Now you'll say, what do you mean? He is a liar. I said he owes me $1,000. He says nothing. And then witnesses come and say he owed me $500. So the Gemara says when a person says that he doesn't owe me the money, that doesn't mean that he's a liar. It just means that he doesn't have the money right now and he's going to pay it when he gets his hands on it. That doesn't make him a clear liar. You see, a deposit is different. Because if I gave Barry a deposit of my Kosh Eliyo, he's not allowed to use it. So if he says he gave it back to me, or it was stolen, and the witnesses say they saw it there, he's proven to be a liar. That's different. And that's what the Gemara says. Ube'edim yurzik kafrin, if there's witnesses, is he proven to be a liar? And here the Gemara says a very subtle distinction. V'amar Rav Idi Bar Rav and Amar Rav Chista, ha'koyfer b'milva. If Barry denies a loan, kosher le'edus, he could still testify at a chasana. He could still be an aid under the chuppah. I mean, I don't know why anybody would give him edus, but he could still be an aid under the chuppah. He could still get away with it. Because we say that it's not that he's saying that he doesn't owe me the money. He's just pushing it off until he gets the dollars together because a loan is given to be spent, so he doesn't have the money. So he's just avoiding it. He's pushing it off until he gets the money together. But b'pikadon pasaleidus. But if he denies a deposit is not meant to be used. And therefore, if he says that he doesn't have it, and the witnesses see he does have it, so he's a clear liar. So then he's pasaleidus. Says the Gemara, but the Gemara still has a problem. Elaporechochi. Malet sada shavashibem shekein einon b'toyres hazama. Remember we said that if Barry admits to owing me money, and he says, Rabbi Weiss, I remember it was in the Staten Island Mall, on Rosh Chodesh Adar Aleph, you gave me a loan of $1,000. Even if Mel and Menachem come and say that Barry couldn't have been there because on that day he was in Dubai, there's no hazama. Because Hoydas Baldin Kamei Eidin Dami. His admission is just solid. And therefore there's no hazama by a person's admission. And there's also no hazama by Eirech. The din of hazama means, hazama, the din of that we do put to the witnesses, kasher zamam lasis la'achiv, that means that if two witnesses come and say that Chatzkel killed somebody, and he gets the death sentence, and then two other witnesses come and say that, look, you couldn't have saw that murder, because on that day you weren't there, and that day you were with us in Atlantic City, then those two witnesses get the death sentence. We do to them what they plotted to do to their brother. Now that's only possible by two witnesses, because two witnesses could cause somebody to get executed, or two witnesses could cause somebody to pay. But one witness cannot cause somebody to pay, because ein davar shebamamid paras mishnayim. So therefore, there can't be hazama by one witness. So the Gemara says, so that's a common denominator. There's a common denominator that both Barry's own admission and one witness doesn't have hazama. Ein abitaris hazama. Taimer be'edim, two witnesses, sheyeshnan abitaris hazama. So here the Gemara says an interesting rule. Haloi kasha, this is not difficult. Because Reb Chia toiris hazama loy parach. The only way we would ask that there's a common denominator is if that common denominator is a chumrah, and therefore there would be a reason to say that only by these two items would they be mechayev a shvua, but not by two edim. So it has to be something that's more powerful. But the fact that one witness doesn't have azama, that's not a power in the witness. To the contrary, it's a weakness in the witness. That it's a weakness in the witness, that the witness is not strong enough to cause an effect that we should then give instead to the false witnesses, because one witness is not so it's not a strength, it's a weakness, and from a weakness we don't ask a pirka, we don't ask a refutation. Okay, but the Gemara says, okay, we have now a proof that if I say to Barry, owe me $1,000, and he says he owes me nothing, and witnesses come and say that he owes me $500, he has to swear about the other $500. And that's a good proof. However, Ella dekama betana tuna, what you wanted to say that there's a proof to this from our Mishnah, I'm sorry, our Mishnah is not similar. Me dummy, what's the comparison? Hosam lemalva islay sade. I have witnesses that Barry owes me $500, but leleva less lay sade. Barry doesn't have any witnesses delay masik leleva lay me day that he doesn't owe me anything. The avile sade. If Barry would have opposing witnesses. If Barry would have opposing witnesses that he doesn't owe me anything, Reb Chia would not make him swear. But in the case of our Mishnah, where AB and Eddie are both holding the talis, Shnayim Oichsim Talis, AB and Eddie are both holding the talis, Hacha, Kiechi, what we said that when AB is holding the talis, that's like a non-sade. That's like a witness that part is his. And when Eddie is holding the talis, it's like a witness that part is his. And yet, even though they both have witnesses, hocha kiechid anan sade bahai, Barry has AB has witnesses, and Eddie has witnesses, and yet, vafilu achi mishtavi, yet we make them both swear. So obviously that's for a different reason. It's like we said, a takana, a special takana schachamim, shele lo yehe kol echad ve'echad, that every person shouldn't go and grab somebody's talis and say that part of it is his. So therefore the Gemara says, if you want to know what is a raya from our Mishnah, so now the Gemara introduces a new case. And this case is a subject of a tremendous machloikis rishonim. Of what the parameters of this case is. But we're going to learn simple. What happens over here is we don't want to abuse Marshall with inattention. So what happens over here is I say, Marshall, you owe me $100. And he says, I owe you 50, and here it is. Now the question is, does he have to swear about the other 50? Now there's two ways to look at this. One way is I made a claim for 100, and he gives me 50, that's tantamount to admitting to 50. So he's Maida b'mikzas ha-taina, and he swears on the rest. Or do we say, when I say you owe me 100, and he gives me the 50, so that means there really is only a claim for 50. And the 50 he's denying completely. And where he denies it completely, he doesn't have to swear. So let's see the case inside. Ella, ki itmar v'tana tuna, when it says that this is covered in our Mishnah, a'idach d'Rav Chiya itmar, it's going on another dictum of Rav Chiya. Dam Rav Chiya, for Rav Chiya says, mana li biyotcha, Marshall, you have $100 of mine. A Marshall says, And Marshall says, "Ein lecha b'yadi al anunzos. I only have dealings with you for 50, and here it is. Here it is. So Rav Chiya says chayiv. Rav Chiya says that Marshall has to swear because I made a taina for 100. He gives me 50. That's tantamount to admitting to 50. So he's made the b'mikzas." Maida b'mikzas ha'tayni yeshava. If you admit to part of the tayni, you have to swear. My time, what's the reason? Heilach nami, when he says here it is, k'maida b'mikzas ha'tayni dami. It's like he's admitting to part of the claim. On that, v'tona tuna. On that, the Gemara wants to say that this is implied from our Mishnah. Because our Mishnah says, shnayim oichzim betalis, edi and abi. Are both holding a talis. Each one says that the talis is his. Now, the ha-hacha, in this case, came the toughest, since Eddie is holding his part, that's tantamount, the Anan Sade, the minded toughest helichu, that what Eddie is holding is his. So that's like AB is admitting that part is his. And where AB admits that part of his, it says in our Mishnah that they each have to swear. V'ketani yeshava. And it says in our Mishnah that they each have to swear. Now Rav Sheshet says no. Rav Sheshet says, this is not my demimixis. When Marshall gives me the 50, that creates it that the 50 is out of the picture. So therefore, the real claim is only for 50. And on that, Marshall doesn't admit to anything. And since he doesn't admit to anything, he doesn't have to swear. Rav Shesh is on a Heluch Potter. Why? My time, it came into Amalei Heluch, since he says, here's the 50. Hani Zuzei de Kamaydi Begavayu. The 50 that he's admitting to, Kamanda Nakalei Malvadami. It's as if I already have it. And therefore, my claim is only for 50. And on that, Marshall is not admitting to anything. Hilkach leka hoidon b'miksa satanet. There's no admission. What about our Mishnah? Ul Rav Sheshet kashin masnisen. Amalach Rav Sheshet. No, our Mishnah is special takonas chachamimi. Like we learned earlier, there's a special takonas chachamim that if we're not going to make Shua, then if Shelley likes my Atara, he'll come by me by davening, grab the talis and say that it's his. So therefore, in order that people shouldn't start grabbing each other's talisim, especially with Barry lurking around, right? So they made a takon. Says the Gemara.
Barry needs a real big one.
If you hear background noise, Rabbi Isai, it's only because somebody didn't mute themselves. I can't figure out who would do that in the middle of a difficult Gemara, but maybe somebody here. I don't know. But anyway, says the Gemara, the Idach, the other opinion says, you're right, in Takanas Chachamimi, but you have to know that we have a klal called the Tikkun Rabbanan ein doraisa tikkun. Whatever the Rabbanan make it in, institute something, it parallels a biblical law. And therefore, miu, I amrit bishleima midoraisa heilachayiv, if we're, I ask Marshall, you owe me $100, and he says it's 50, and here it is, that he has to swear on the rest. So misakne Rabbanan shvua kein doraisa. The Rabbanan will make a shvua that's akin to the biblical law. Eliyam midoraisa eilach potter, would misakne Rabbanan shvua, would Rabbanan make a shvua by the case of the talis, the lesser the kavasa midoraisa, that doesn't have some parallel by the biblical oath. Now, meisvei, as we turn to Amud Beis, and by the way, Rabbi Say, as Irving said, these Gemaras are quite difficult. As we welcome in Shimon Deer for our 39th Zoomer of the evening, 39, and since Michal Avram is together with Avram Rezepkowitz, that's 40, and with Sandy and Richard Rosenzweig, that's 42. So Marshall is eight from the promised land.
I'm only motive amixas on that. I think I'm already there.
Now, you're not all there. Now, if a document, now before we learn the next Gemara, let me tell you a principle all over Shas. And that is when it says a plural, like dogim, basim, fish, houses, we have a klal that miyat rabim shnayim, that when it says a plural, we assume it means two, because we could only assume the smallest amount. That's called tafasta maruba loy tafasta. We don't assume more. So when it says a plural, we assume two. Now the case is as follows. I produce on Marshall a document that he owes me sloim or dinarim. Sloim or dinarim. Now, so the minimum would be two. What happens is malva amar chamesh. I say that Marshall owes me five. While the loiva amar shalosh, while Marshall admits to three. Now, this is interesting. Reb Shimon ben Elazar Eimer, Hayil v'hayda mixes atana. See, since he admits to part, Yeshava, he has to swear. Rabbi Kiva says, no, Marshall, there's a special law that if Machal Avram picks up a wallet and he sees it has Barry Cement's license in it, and he returns it to Barry with $500 cash, and Barry claims that it had $1,000 cash, Michal Avram doesn't have to swear. He's protected because we don't want him to avoid returning wallets. If he's going to have to swear, then he's going to say, what do I need this for? I'm not picking it up. So we give him a special amnesty because he's doing the mitzvah of Asher Zaveda. Now, Rabbi Akiva says, Marshall gets that amnesty over here. Because I asked for five, and he admitted to three. He didn't have to admit to three. He could have said, Rabbi Weiss, the document says sloin. Miat rabim is two. I'm only giving you two. He admitted to three. He's returning me an extra one that he didn't have to return. And therefore, he doesn't have to swear. That's Rabbi Kiva's svar. Let's see it inside. Rabbi Kiva Eimer, Eina Ela Kameshia Vavedi, he's only like returning a lost article. Upatar, again, why is he like returning a lost article? Because since the document said slum, he could say, listen, it says slum, the smallest plural is two, I'm only giving you two, and go stand on your head. But he went ahead and admitted to an extra one, and therefore he's like a Meshiv Aveda, like returning a lost article, and therefore he's parted from swearing. Now, Kitani Mias, it says, Reb Shimon ben Elazar, Imahoyel v'hoyda mixas hataina, since Marshall admitted to three, Yeshava. Ah, but time Adam is shalosh. But that's only if he admits to three. Hashtayim, but if he says two, potter. Now, why is he potter? He's potter because v'hai shtar de kamoidebe helechu. What he admitted to was what was in the shtar. Now, what's in the shtar, since I'm holding a shtar, I have a lien on his karka, so it's like I already have two. So you see that when he admits to the two that I already have, and he denies the other three, we're not going to make him swear. So you see, by halach, we don't make a person swear. Time adam ishtalish, hashtayim pater. So you see where he says, look, the two, that's already in the bag because you have a shtar and you have a lien on my karka. The other three, I deny. So that's considered not a moida b'mixas. That's considered like he's denying the whole claim. So you see, halach is pater from a shvua. Says the Gemara loy. Loy la meimelach shtayim chayiv. That even if he only admits to two, he would also be chayav to swear about the other three. V'hai de ketani shalosh, and that which it says, the case of three and not the case of two, that's that Rabbi Eliezer ben Yaakov is disagreeing with Rabbi Akiva, that where he says three, he gets the amnesty of Hashavas Aveda. V'hai de ketani shalosh, that's lafuke mit Rabbi Akiva, d'amar meshev aveda ave. He's like one who's returning a lost article of Potter. K'mash melon, that no, it's still a case of moida b'mixas hatayna ave, v'chayiv. Says the Gemara, if they're also arguing on two, then Rav Shimon ben Elazar should have worded his thing differently. Ihachi Rav Shimon ben Elazar Omer Hayo v'Hayda Mixas Hatayna Yeshava. He shouldn't have said that since he's Mayda b'Mixas Hatayna, Marshall has to swear. He should have said Afze Yeshava Mabayle, even in the case of three, because he says in the case of two he would also have to swear. Rather, El Olam Shtayim Potter, where Marshall said he owes me two, Hitaka doesn't have to swear. But not because of Halach. Maybe the Halach Chayiv, in the case of Halach, where Marshall says, here's the 50, he would be Chayiv to swear. The reason why over here that Marshall doesn't have to swear is because he has a shtar that backs him up. He says, Rabbi Weiss, read the promissory note. It says Slum. Stam Slum is two. I'm only giving you two. Hacha, Vashani Hacha, and it's different over here, the Kamasayale Shtara. The Shtar backs him up, it's only two. Inami, there's another clever reason why Marshall doesn't have to swear. Because since I have a Shtar that he owes me two, once I have a note, it's not an oral loan, it's a written contract, I have a lien on his karka for that too. And once real estate is involved, Einish ba'an ala karkois. Inami, mishum da'avalei shtar shibud karkois. I have a document that gives me a lien on his real estate. Ve'einish ba'an al kvir shibud karkois. We have a rule that you don't swear about a denial on a claim on real estate, because Einish ba'an ala karkois. The Gemara now goes in a different direction, a different spin. And if your head is spinning, I want to tell you, I want to be very frank with you. I prepare usually, when I'm in Lakewood, I learn in Satmar in the morning, and I have a Seder. At first I do the Mishneh Yomis, then I do the Daf, and after that I either work on the Chumash or I work on the Chok, I work on the for the Shabbos table. And then I usually don't look at the Daf again during the day before the shiur. This morning, I davened in BRS at 9:15. I worked on the daf over an hour, and then I came home. I played some pickleball in the sun, and I had to look at the daf again. This is not easy Gemara. So if you're finding it a little tricky and a little challenging, I will tell you that your mind will get used to the reasoning. Give it a little time. Your mind will get, you're getting more of a Talmudic mind. Now, the Gemara says if you want to be a Chakima, learn Nezikin. This stretches the mind. So you get a Talmudic mind. As we welcome in Robert Mazeratsky, Richard Hauptmann, joining us here as well. The Gemara says, what?
Closer to 50 yet?
No, it's. I just realized that I can't count you. You're not behaving.
What else is
Yeah, we're getting close, Marshall. We're getting close. Keep on working. Keep on working those phones. Ika de Moisiv mi Seifa. Some ask from the latter part, from Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Akiva Aimer, remember Rabbi Akiva says that I have a note that says that Marshall owes me slot or dinarin. And I say it's 5, and he says it's 3. So Rabbi Akiva says, Marshall doesn't have to swear, because he's returning me extra money. He only had to admit to 2, because Rabbim is 2. When he returns me extra, it's like he's picking something up from the street and returning it to me. And then he has the amnesty of not having to swear, like in the case where Michal Avram found a wallet, that we don't make him swear. There's a special protection of a Meshiv Aveda. Oh, Yitz Fuchs is coming in now. That's our 40th Zoomer, Rabbi Say. It's been a while since we've had 40 Zoomers, and it all started when Barry came back to the shir. All bracha heads to Barry, and if that's the case, we're all in a lot of trouble. But anyway, Barry, it's great to have you. It's great to have you. If you don't know who Barry is, by the way, if you're new to the shir, many years ago I went over to Barry and I said, you're going to be the next Gabbai. And he told me I'm crazy. And then he went on to have a career of a Gabbai for over a decade, a great career as a Gabbai, a real natural. I'm going to tell you a secret, Rabbi Isai. I know it's in the middle of a Gemara, and it's a distraction, but I'm going to tell you what one of the important qualities of a good Gabbai is. A good Gabbai has to be able to laugh at himself. If a Gabbai is going to take things too personally, then he's going to yell at the people that are not behaving correctly. And when you yell at the people that are not behaving, then they become your enemies, and they get worse. But Barry had the proper makeup of how to laugh with the people that were maybe not behaving the right way with him. And that is an essential quality of a successful Gabbai. The Gemara tells us, Ika de Moisiv mi Seifa. There are those that ask from the Seifa. Rabbi Kiva Aimer, Eina Ela Kemeshiv Aveda, when Barry admits to the 3, excuse me, when Marshall admits to the 3, he's returning me an extra 1, O Potter. Ah. But says the Gemara, the implication is Taima only because he admitted to 3. Taima Dama Shalash. Hoshtayim, if he says he only owes me 2, Chayiv. Ah, he's Chayiv. But the fact that I have a shtar about the 2 means that those 2, it's like it's already in the bag because I have a lien on the real estate. So that's like Halach, like he gave me the 2. And yet we say that he has to swear about the other 3. Vashtar, the Kamaidabay, the note, which he admits to the two, Kehelech Dami. It's like I already have it because I have a lien on the karka. So Shmami no Helech Chayiv. So you see that even though it's as if I already have the two, when he denies the other three, it's considered still Maida B'mikzas, and he has to swear. Says no. That if he says that I owe you two, he's also potter. And now which it says three, that's coming to exclude from Rav Shimon ben Elazar, who says that by three, where he says he owes me three, he also has to swear, that by three, since he's returning an extra one, the Meshav Aveda Aveyopater. Oh, but says the Gemara, and Hakanami Mistavra. It's Mistavra that where he says two, he's going to be Potter. The Iso Kedaitach Shtayim Chayiv, because if you'll say that where he says he owes me two, he has to swear, so then. How could we say that when Marshall says three, he's potter from swearing? Maybe he's only saying three, so he should get out of swearing, because if he said two, he would have to swear. Says the Gemara, Esau kedait d'shtayim chayiv, b'sholosh sheichi potter le Rabbi Kiva. When he admits to three, how could Rabbi Kiva say he's potter? There's a very strong reason to say, hayarume kamarim. He's being just deceitful. He's just being shrewd. Savar I amin ashtayim. If I say two, boina ishtavui, I have to swear. Ema shosh, I'll say three, so I don't have to swear. Davi kameshiv aveda v'ifter. El ishmami no, the Gemara says, shtayim nami potter. Oh, says the Gemara. But if two is potter, even though it's like helach, because we said that I have a lien on it for two, so it's like I already have it. And we see that where it's Halach, and he denies the other three, because I'm claiming five, we see he's potter from swearing. So that's Shver and Rav Chiya that says by Halach, you're chayiv to swear. Elakash and Rav Chiya says to Gemara, no. Maybe normally where I say, Marshall, you owe me 100, and he gives me 50, and he denies the other 50, maybe he does have to swear. The reason if where he admits to two, he doesn't have to swear, is for a different reason. Because he says, read the document. It says Slum. The document backs me out. Slum is two. The minimum plural is two. Shani Hossam to come Sayle Shtara. He's backed up by a document. Or Inami, like I said, because since this is an issue where I have a written contract, so I have a lien on his real estate. Once we deal with real estate, there's no oaths. Inami mishum davle shtar shibit karkois. It's a document which has a lien on real estate. Vein nishpon al kfir shibit karkois. So we don't swear where it's a denial about lien on karka, because there's no oaths that are connected to real estate. Rather, the Gemara, one final piece of Gemara over here, Rabbi Isai. And this is, as I said, this is not for the boys. This separates the men from the boys. This is a intricate Gemara. And
why fit in?
You're just for comic relief. You asked a question, Barry, right? Barry, by the way, Barry remembers these Gemaras from his yeshiva days. Right? Barry used to sit in the Beis Medrash for many long hours, right?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, and those are probably from the sweetest memories of your life.
That's because you got kicked out of Shear, Barry? You have to sit in the
base mattress? What's a
Shear? but seriously, Barry was once a big boy on campus.
Those are the old days.
Rabbi, question?
No, not yet. Now, not yet. Let's get moving over here so that people don't kalish. Baruch Ian might be playing late night pickleball. We don't know. It's very nice at the Shtibel on Shabbos Baruch. Baruch Davins, we have two Fairways representatives at the Shtibel, Baruch and Reb Hirsch, two Fairways representatives, good representatives. Baruch, should I have spoken in Yiddish?
No.
No.
I think you did the right thing.
I did the right thing.
Yeah. You gave it to them. I like it.
Anyway. Yeah, now. Okay. So, Masiv Marzutra Breid Rav Nachman. To Anu Kalim Vikarkois. I say that Barry owes me vacuum cleaners and real estate. Hoyda Bekalim, he admits to the vacuum cleaners, Vikafer Bekarkois, he denies the real estate. Or Hoyda Bekarkois, or he admits the real estate, Vikafer Bekalim, and he denies the vacuum cleaners. Potter. Because like we said, we don't swear about karka, about real estate. So whether the denial or the admission had to do with real estate, it's potter. Hoida bekarka, excuse me, hoida mixes karka is potter. If he admits, I claim that he owes me two fields and vacuum cleaners, and he admits to one of the fields, again he's potter. But if I say that he owes me a field and five snow blowers, and what he does is he admits to mixas kalim, he admits to two of the snow blowers, then he's chayiv. Even if there's a karka in the mix too, but since he admits to some of the snow blowers and denies some of the snow blowers, so that's a case of maida b'mixas ataina, and he has to swear. Now, here the Gemara asks a nifty question. Remember, by karka, karka is never truly stolen. It's never moved from its place. That's the idea of karka ain't an exelis. You can never really steal karka. You're not going to move it to a different place. You could occupy it, but you can't steal it. So the Gemara says, taima de kalim v'karkois. Where is he potter from shvua? In the case where he either admits to utensils and denies the real estate, or denies the utensils and admits the real estates. The karka la bashvui, because as we said, anything connected to karka, there's no shvua. Ha kalim v'kalim dumya, the kalim v'karkais. But if it's a case of utensils and utensils that are similar to utensils and real estate, and what would that be? Where I say, Barry, you owe me five Electroluxes, five vacuum cleaners. And he says, here's two, and I don't owe you another three. In such a case, that's like Kalim and Karka. Because by saying, here's two, he's saying that it was never stolen. Here it is. And yet in that case, the implication is that he would have to swear. So you see that by Halach, you do have to swear. That's the Gemara's kasha. Ha Kalim v'Kalim, dumya de Kalim v'Karka, is tayyib. Heichi dummy. Lav de ka'amar, isn't it talking about lav de amalei Halach? Here's three Electroluxes. Ushmami na, that when he says, here's three Electroluxes and I deny the other two, he has to swear. Ushmami na chela chayiv, it would be a riot to Reb Chiya. Loi. Lo'aylam emala kelem v'kelem nami potter. In such a case, you'd be potter from swearing. V'adik tani kelem v'karkois, ha'kamash malon, here's an interesting thing. If I say, Barry, you owe me five snowblowers and a field, and he admits to three snowblowers, he has to spear about the real estate too. And even though normally einish ba'en ala karkois, but once he has to swear about the remaining two snowblowers, he has to swear about the karka too. says the Gemara, V'adiktani kelim v'kakois ha'kamash malon. Hoida b'mixas kelim. If he admits to the snowblowers, he admits to three of the snowblowers, chayiv ala karkois. Yeah, chayiv af ala karkois. He has to swear about the real estate too. So the Gemara says, my kamash moats the chiddush that zaykikin, that once you swear about movables, we could schlep you to swear about the real estate too. We learned that. We already learned that in Masechtas Kedushin. Zaykikin an nechosim shein l'rem achrayis. When you have to swear about movables, that will cause you to have to swear about real estate. So we already learned that once you swear about movables, that could generate that you have to swear about the real estate too. Says, well, you're right. This case in Masechta Shavuos is the main source. Hasam in Kedushin, Agav Grora Noscha. Because it was talking about other kinyonim, it mentions it incidentally, but that's not the main source. The main source is the sugya in Shavuos. Now, Mitzvah Hashem, tomorrow we will continue this sugya at 8 o'clock. I hope that we get all 40 people back tomorrow. We're going to learn the Mishnah Yomis now.